Awaking in Africa. 35 article. Awaking in Africa. In my article, I discuss a process of transformation and awakening of awareness in Africa. Panelist by interactions with figures I call real guides, not Abel Ribada, Paul and Dwayne Eva. This awakening manifests as a distancing from false masters and a redefinition of our relationship with all is and the real guides. In this essay, I will explore the implications of this collective awareness, the role of new technologies in this process, and the importance of gratitude towards this real guides. When I say we sing the new you together, it symbolizes an act of communion and unite among us. This collective practice emphasizes the importance of our real and is identity while marking a break from traditions of seen as alienating. By coming together around a shared experience, we strengthen our sense of belonging and our power to act as a more aware community. The rejection of false masters illustrates our desire for discernment of real autonomy. This aspect is particularly significant in a context where many of us have long relied on charismatic figures, often bearing dogmatic discourses. By freeing ourselves from this grip, we affirm our right to an authentic life based on personal experience and self-discovery. This process of disenchantment is essential for developing a critical consciousness towards inherited beliefs. The use of platforms like Skype and WhatsApp to share our real experience demonstrates the importance of modern technologies in this awakening process. These tools allow us to connect instantly and transcend geographical barriers, facilitating access to exchange we consider beneficial. The digital dimensions creates a space for dialogue and exchanges of ideas, enriching our individual and collective perspectives. Expressing our gratitude towards the real is a fundamental aspect of our transformation. By doing so, we affirm a respectful and egalitarian relationship with these real figures. This reflects our understanding that awakening is a shared journey where the guides play a role of companions rather than authoritarian leaders. This dynamic fosters a collaborative approach to all is, where each of us is responsible for our own path. In conclusion, my article highlights a vibrant movement of awareness in Africa, supported by meaningful interactions with the real guides. This process is actuated by the use of the new address, new you, through our rejection of dogmas im Post bei False Masters. Our gratitude towards the guides and bullies, a new is area where being is at the center of its own awakening. This phenomenon paves the way for a more aware, autonomous Africa in search of real authenticity. For those who are new stands and new leaders, they have a great education that is constantly taking place, whether they are fully aware of it or not. The human self will always be the last to know, and one of the best things to practice is great patience with oneself. As we continue to practice being now, we eventually see beyond what the eyes and mind always observe. At some point, we come to a point where we are more than comfortable with ourselves because we are in the process of being now. Being now is the best real position to take, but we also need the real guidance and real education that continues. Little Torwart.